Hello, my dear students. In this lecture, we are going to see one best quality question on the conduction through a composite slab. Now, let us understand the question. The question is, a layer of 5 cm thick insulating brick having conductivity of 1.5 watt per meter Kelvin is placed between two 0.5 cm thick steel plates. Thermal conductivity is 50 watt per meter Kelvin. Now, my dear students, here they have given one insulating brick material. Let us say this is a brick. Right. Here, if I draw a diagram of brick, let us say this is a brick. Right. This will be the brick. Now, here, this brick is, here they have given 5 cm thick. Therefore, this thickness, we can say this distance will be 5 centimeter, as well as thermal conductivity of brick they have given, that is 1.5. therefore, this thermal conductivity of brick will be equal to 1.5 watt per meter Kelvin. Now, in question they have mentioned that this brick plate is placed between two 0.5 centimeter thick steel plates having thermal conductivity 50 watt per meter Kelvin. Now, let us draw here steel plates, but before drawing steel plates, let us understand the further statements, because they have further given some information. Now, the faces of brick adjacent to the plates are rough. Now, these faces of this brick, that is left face as well as right face, is rough, having solid to solid contact of 30% of the total area. Right? There is only 30% of total area is in solid to solid contact, and the remaining area, that is 70% area, will be in contact with air only. Right. Then the average height of asperities is 0.1 centimeter. Means, my dear students, from both sides, because of this surface roughness, the asperities are for 0.1 centimeter. Means, here there will be asperities like this. Let us say this is asperities, surface irregularities, right, like this on both sides. And of this asperities, if I see the height, they have given this height, let us say for both, they have given 0.1 centimeter. Here also 0.1 centimeter. Right. And my dear students, for this 0.1 centimeter on both sides, there is a rough surface. And they have mentioned that here, the faces of brick adjacent to the plates, here to the steel plates, plates means to the steel plates, are rough, having solid to solid contact of 30%. Means here the solid to solid contact is only 30%. The remaining contact will be with air only. Let us say this is solid to solid contact, right? Only 30%. And after that there are steel plates. Right? Let us say there is a steel plate like this. This is a steel plate. Right? These are both sides, they have given steel plate. Now, my dear students, for this steel plate, they have given 0.5 centimeter thickness, right? Therefore, here, this distance is 0.5 centimeter, 0.5 centimeter. Again, here, this distance is 0.5 centimeter, right? And this is a steel. Here, you can say this is a steel. On both sides, this is a steel, right? For 0.5 centimeter thickness. And thermal conductivity of steel is given 50 watt per meter Kelvin. Right, here thermal conductivity of steel is given 50 watt per meter Kelvin. Right, and after that, right, if the outer plate surface temperature are 100 degrees Celsius and 500 degrees Celsius respectively, calculate the rate of heat transfer per unit area. Now, outer surface temperatures are 100 degrees Celsius and 500 degrees Celsius. Let us say this surface temperature, which is at temperature T1, and this surface temperature at temperature T2. Let us say one surface is at temperature 100 degrees Celsius, and other temperature, other surface at 500 degrees Celsius. This is the given data, right? Therefore, as T1, I am assuming more than T2, the heat will flow from T1 to T2. That is, the direction of heat flow will be towards, here we can say towards right. The direction of heat flow will be left to right. Right? This will be the direction of heat flow. Right? Heat is flowing in along x direction. Now, let us understand, my dear students. My dear students, in this surface roughness, only 30, now here brick is rough surface, steel is not rough surface. Means this rough surface I have shown for the brick only. And this, in this surface roughness, the 30% of this brick is in contact with steel only, right? Therefore, for 30% of area only, there is a conduction in brick in this 0.1 centimeter thickness, right? And remaining for 70% of area, there is a conduction in air, right? And my dear students, here in this 0.1 centimeter only, I am saying in this 0.1 centimeter only, there is the air and this brick are in parallel. Your air and brick are in parallel. And for rest all, this steel, brick and steel are in series, right? And in between, the air and brick are in parallel. So let us draw here equivalent circuit. Now here, the resistance, we know that the resistance for a slab, thermal resistance for the slab is L divided by KA, right? This is the thermal resistance formula for the slab. So let us find here resistance. Now here, for this first steel of 0.5 centimeter towards left, there will be a resistance R1, right? Again, in this 0.1 centimeter thickness, there is a resistance of brick as well as resistance of air, but resistance of brick and air are in parallel. Resistance of brick and resistance of air are in parallel. And for brick, only 30% area, and for air, there is a 70% area. Again, there will be a resistance of brick in this wall, in this plate. And again, in these asperities, there will be a resistance of air as well as resistance of brick in parallel. And again, in steel, there will be a resistance. These are the various resistance. Let us understand this. Now, here I am going to erase the question so that we will get sufficient space for the solution. Now, here I am going to draw the circuit. And thermal conductivity of air is also given. Right here, thermal conductivity of air is also given. Now, my dear students, resistance for the slab is L divided by KA. Now, let us draw the circuit. Now, whenever the temperature is T1, between temperature T1, let us say various temperatures at various location. Here this is a T1, let us say this is a T3, let us say T4, let us say T5, and T6, and then T2. Now between T1 and T3, there is a resistance of steel. Therefore, let us find this resistance of steel. Right. Therefore, here I can say between T1 from 1 to 3, T1 to T3, that is 3, this is a point 3. Right. Here T1. T3, there is a resistance of steel, which is equal to R1, will be equal to resistance of steel is here. Can I say L divided by KA? Right, L is length is here 0.5 centimeter, convert into meter 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 2. Right, resistance 1 will be here 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by K. Thermal conductivity of steel we have to consider here. Thermal conductivity of steel is given 50. Into area, right? This will be the R1 between T1 and T3, right? Between T3 and T4, there is a resistance of air as well as resistance of brick in parallel. Therefore, my dear students, between T3 and T4, there are two resistances. There will be a resistance in air as well as resistance in brick, right? And here there will be a T4, right? This is a 4 point, or here temperature will be T4. Now let us say here resistance in brick, that is R2, which is equal to, let us say resistance in brick I am writing, right? The thickness is 0.1 centimeter, therefore it can be written as 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 2, right? Thickness is 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by. Now, thermal conductivity of brick is, they have provided the value of thermal conductivity as 1.5, therefore it is 1.5 into area. Now, there is an area of contact of brick is 30% only. Therefore, here we have to write 0.3 into area, because only 30% area is in contact. Right. So, my dear students, let us write it properly. Right. Let us write it properly. Right. Therefore, here there is a temperature T4. Now, my dear students, because 30% of area is in contact only, solid to solid. Therefore, 0.3A we have to write here. 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by 1.5 into 0.3. into area. Now here R3 is resistance of air. Let us say R3 is resistance of air. Now for air, again thickness is 0.1 centimeter. Therefore 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by. Thermal conductivity of air is given 0.02. Therefore 0.02 into area is now 70%. because 30% gone for a brick, so 70% is for air only, 0.7 into area, right? Again, from T4 to T5, there is a resistance of completely brick, right? Therefore, from temperature T4 to temperature T5, we can say, let us say this is a temperature T5. Resistance of brick, let us say, this is R4. Therefore, resistance of brick will be, here thickness will be 5 cm. Therefore, I can write 5 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by. Thermal conductivity of brick is 1.5 into area is complete area. For this intermediate brick, area is complete area. Now, again, the same circuit will offer there, right? That is R2 and R3 again will come into series. Let us say, sorry, parallel. R2 and R3 again will come into parallel because same thickness, same contacting area for the brick and air. Therefore, again here, between T5 and T6, the same R2, which is nothing but 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by 1.5, it is, let me write it clearly, divided by 1.5 into 0.3 into area. This will be the R2, right? This will be the R2, and there will be R3 also. There will be R3 also. R3 is 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by 0.02 into 0.7 into area, and temperature will become T6. Right, temperature will become T6 here. Right, let us say temperature is T6. Now, my dear students, between temperature T6 and T2, again there is a resistance of steel. And resistance of steel is, again, for steel plate, the thickness is 0.5 cm on both sides. Thermal conductivity is same, area is same. Therefore, same R1 will repeat. Same R1 will repeat between 6 and 2. Therefore, between temperature T6 and T2, same R1 will repeat. Here we have already calculated R1. 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by 50A. Right. This will be the circuit here, my dear students. Now, through this circuit, the heat is flowing. Through this circuit, heat is flowing. Q. Right. Heat is flowing through this circuit. Right. Heat is flowing. Now, my dear students, here, first of all, to find this heat, we know that the heat is nothing but change in temperature divided by resistance. Therefore, if I write T1 minus T2, because here T1 minus T2 is given. Temperature T1 is known 500 degrees Celsius, T2 is known 100 degrees Celsius. Therefore, if I write T1 minus T2, then I have to calculate the total equivalent resistance. Total equivalent resistance. Right. Now, one, the R2 and R3 are in parallel. Therefore, reciprocal of them will get added. Again, R2 and R3 are in parallel here. Therefore, for this parallel, first find the equivalent resistance. And then the equivalent of R2 and R3 will be in series with R1, R4 and R1. Right. So let us find this equivalent resistance. Now here they have given T1 is equal to 500 degrees Celsius and T2 is equal to 100 degrees Celsius. Right. Now, my dear students, here let us find the equivalent resistance for this circuit. So here I am going to erase this diagram. Therefore, my dear students, here between temperature T1, let us say T1. To T3, between T1 and T3, the R1 will be there, and the value of R1 I will find 1 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by area. This will be the R1. Again, from T3 to T4, there is R2, this R2 and R3 in parallel, right? R3 in parallel. So let us find these values. So here R2 will be equal to 2.22 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by area. And R3, let us find R3. Here this R3 will be 0.0714 divided by area. Right. And after that, there will be a temperature T4. Now there will be a R4 again. Right. There will be a R4 again between T4 and T5. So let us find this R4. We have values here. So my dear students, this R4 I will get 0.0333 divided by area, and between T5 and T6 there is R2 and R3 again in parallel, and R2 already we have calculated 2.22 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by area, as well as R3 we have calculated, which is nothing but 0.0714 divided by area. Then temperature becomes 6, right? After T6 there is R1 again. Up to T2, there is R1 again, and R1 value already we have calculated 1 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by area. Right, this will be the circuit here. Right, now my dear students, here temperature is T6. Here temperature is T6. Right, now my dear students, here let us find the equivalent for R2 and R3. First of all, how to find equivalent of R2 and R3? Now 1 upon R equivalent 1 is equivalent of R2 and R3 will be equal to 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. For parallel connection, the equivalent is reciprocal gets added, right? And find this equivalent resistance for R2 and R3 only, right? So let us find this. So if I simplify this, the 1 upon R equivalent, I will get of 1 is equal to R3 plus R2 divided by R2 R3. So my dear students, let us simplify this again formula. If I simplify this formula, the equivalent resistance for R2 and R3 only, I will get, that is R equivalent 1 will be equal to R2 R3 divided by R3 plus R2, right? Therefore, my dear students, here you have values of R2 and R3. Let us put these values of R2 and R3. You will find that R equivalent 1 will be equal to 2.153 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by area. Should be the R equivalent 1. So let us draw this equivalent circuit, right? So my dear students, what will happen now? Let us draw the equivalent circuit, right? Now my dear students, here in case of equivalent circuit, here there will be a first resistance R1, here temperature is T1, first resistance R1, then there will be a R equivalent 1, which is equivalent of R2 and R3, then there will be a R4, then there will be a R equivalent 1, then there will be a again R1 and temperature becomes T2, right? You can see here R1, R equivalent of R2 and R3, R4, R equivalent of R2 and R3, and R1, right? Therefore, my dear students, the total resistance for the circuit, total resistance will become R1 plus R equivalent 1 plus R4 plus R equivalent 1 plus R1. This will be the total resistance over here. So let us find this total resistance. We have here values. Let us put these values. Therefore, R total is equal to R1 is 1 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by area plus R equivalent 1 is 2.153 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by area plus R4 is here 0.0333 divided by area plus R equivalent 1. Now this is the R equivalent 1. So let us multiply this R equivalent 1 with 2. Again there is R1. So let us multiply this R1 with 2. Right. So my dear students, we will get R total. So let us find this total resistance in terms of area. Therefore, here I will find this total resistance will be equal to 0.0378 divided by area. Right. This will be the total resistance. And total temperature difference we have T1 is 500 degrees Celsius and T2 is 100 degrees Celsius. So my dear students, let us use the formula now. Therefore, heat transfer will be equal to change in temperature divided by resistance. If I write total change in temperature, that is T1 minus T2, then I have to write total resistance. Therefore, is equal to 500 minus 100 divided by total resistance is 0.0378 divided by area. Right. Now my dear students, divide both sides by area. Therefore, heat transfer per unit area, which is nothing but heat flux, that is watt per meter square, and this is a question, will be equal to 500 minus 100 is 400 divided by 0.0378. So my dear students, this heat flux you will find as 10,580.3 watt per meter square, right? Therefore, let us find in kilowatt. Therefore, Q will be equal to 10.58 kilowatt per meter square. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see one more numerical on this topic.